going to use the standard normal table in reverse. That's the case where we're given an area or a probability first, and we're working backwards to find the corresponding z-score. This is actually very important, especially when you get to the part of your course when you are finding a critical value for a confidence interval or for a hypothesis test. So I want to find the z-score that corresponds to a cumulative, there should be cumulative right here, area of 0.0735 and also 0.8212. And then I also want to find the two symmetric z-scores such that 0.95 amount of area lies between them. So for this first part, I'm given a cumulative area of 0.0735. So I want to sketch what's given. Okay, so the 0.0735 is not a z-score, it's a cumulative area. Now remember, the cumulative area from negative infinity up to zero is 0.5. So if I'm given a cumulative area of 0.0735, I expect my z-score to be negative. And being a reasonably small amount of cumulative area, it's going to be further away from zero. So this is my mystery z-score. And what I'm given first is this cumulative area. Oops, that's a 3. So looking at the standard normal table, because I expect my z-score to be negative, I'm going to be on the first page of my table. Now remember, along the outside of the table are the z-scores, and that's what I'm looking for. And what I'm given is the area or the probability, the cumulative area or the cumulative probability. So looking in the table, I need to get or find the value as close as I can to 0.0735. So reading in the body of the table, here it is, 0.0735. So I can read to the left and then upward to get what that z-score is. So reading to the left, I'm at negative 1.4, and then reading upward, the hundredth place is 0.05. So that z-score is going to be negative 1.45. Now for the second one, my cumulative area, or the area to the left of that z-score, is 0.8212. So sketching what is given, putting 0 in the middle, this cumulative area is greater than 0.5, so I expect my z-score to be positive. So placing it up here and shading to the left, this area that's given is 8212. Okay. So we're working in reverse, we're working backward. Our input now is an area or a probability, and our output is a z-score. That's different than my last several examples where we were given a z-score first, then finding the area or the probability. So because I expect my z-score to be positive, I'm looking at the page of my table that corresponds to positive z-scores. So I want to read in the body of the table as close as I can get to 0.8212, and I happen to pick values that were exactly in the table to make this a little more manageable. Okay, so 0.8212. Of course, now I can't find it. Oh, here it is. Ta-da! All right, so 0.8212, reading to the left, that's going to be a z-score of 0.92. Okay, so the 0.02 is the hundredths place. So that's a z-score of 0.92. So I drew it a little further to the right than I should have, but this sketching it is a visual aid. Okay, it just tells me, am I above zero? Am I below zero? Am I far away from zero? Am I close to zero? Now for this last part, I want to find the two symmetric z-scores such that 0.95 amount of area lies between them. And again, this is a really important example because we will see a lot of this when we get to confidence intervals and hypothesis testing, specifically for a two-tailed hypothesis test. Okay, so I have two symmetric z-scores. So they will be the same with respect to absolute value, okay, but they're going to be opposite in sign. And I'm shading an area between them. And that area I want is 0.95. Okay, so looking at this, this is certainly not a cumulative area, and our table only reads cumulatively. So we need to figure out how much area is in this lower tail. I know the total area under the curve is 1 or 100%. So if 95% is between these two values, that means 5% is left over equitably between the tails. And half of 5% is 2.5%. So as a decimal, this tail has 0.025 amount of area, and this tail has 0.025 amount of area. And you can verify that yourself by summing these up, and they should add to 1. So this gives me my input for my table. So again, this z-score is negative. I need to go to the page that reads for negative z-scores, and I need to read in the body of the table as close as I can get to 0.025. All right, and here it is. Okay, so 0.025, reading to the left, I have negative 1.906, rounding to the nearest hundredth. So this table only goes to the hundredths place. So this negative z-score is negative 1.96. So I don't have to use the table to find the upper z-score. If I wanted to do that, I would have to recognize the fact that there's a cumulative area of 0.975 below this positive z-score. That's 0.025 plus this 0.95. Okay, so I could do that. However, I can use the fact that this distribution is symmetric. So if this z-score is negative 1.96, the upper z-score will be positive 1.96.